Okay, I guess Jaime has the first item, right? Or am I wrong?
Yeah, no, not really. It was more like something to check the priorities in this. I saw Camille had a bunch of items in the Slack channel.
Okay. So you meant check the priorities on the object storage. What's next? That was your comment, or?
Yeah, mostly like from this list, perhaps need to prioritize this a little bit.
I guess if you can share the screen and just go over them quickly, we can just say like. Actually, I don't know what issues are really required for us to go to production, because I don't expect many of them.
All right, you can you see it?
Yeah.
Cool. So,
can you refresh this page?
Sure.
I added one more.
So is this pages 404, right? So I think that MR, I have approved that MR, and I think it's back with Vlad, so this one can be close soonish, I guess. Also, I guess, I don't know how high in priority is this, allowing to zip SERP from disk. Is this something we're looking to, you know, implement?
I guess, I'd say we can do it a little later, at least after, like, while we still have some blockers for .com migration, we can put that aside. But once we run in everything in production and everything works, we can get back to this.
Okay, so
Jamie, what? I think maybe we should start from the other angle, like from the top level priority, and then like we would have much better like idea exactly what we want to achieve and in what direction. Because like this is gonna be needed at some point, but it's actually kind of like we should talk exactly like the items and the timelines of when other items gonna happen. So could we maybe go back to like to our like top level epic about like GitLab pages, object storage or something like that? Because I believe we have the epic for the race site that you are maintaining and the epic for the Golang site, right?
Yep.
Can we, let's just basically go for that. This transition.
So I think it's this one, the one on the Rails side.
Yep. So basically everything which is in here isn't my plan, like in the nearest future. It's going a little slowly just because I don't know, I have a lot of time to review stuff and actually not so much to work on that. But yeah, this is like immediate priority. I hope to finish hopefully all of that in a couple of weeks.
Okay, would you mind, Jamie, opening transition GitLab pages to object storage instead of NFS? Because I think that this is our like top level, what we are aiming for. From what I'm kind of understanding, EMEA did priority, which at least from the perspective of the scalability team and working group is to aim to detach NFS storage from the github.com before the end of the year. That's kind of like the goal that we are aiming for. So we want to make github.com run GitLab pages using a migrated zip, ideally before the end of the year. That's our really goal that we are aiming for. So now like the question is like, how complete is this status? Because like the current status here is, for example, It's exactly from like yesterday. We have in progress deploy pages, zip archives to object storage, local storage when pages are deployed. So this is something that you, Vladimir, are working on right now, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's take a look at that one.
So yeah, basically
add object storage settings to Omnibus. How it looks?
Actually, I hope it's already merged. I haven't looked at it yet today, but it was on the maintainer review yesterday, and I need to only add docs there. So this one is kind of finished. Clean the second two. I started on them, but didn't have much time. Hopefully, it will take me not that long. Actually, I don't know, a day or so.
So like clean all pages on basic deployment. Can we reorder this stuff? Can you finish 256 and move cleanup later?
I mean, I actually don't want to enable feature flag without all of them being done. I don't know. I can do like. I mean, I can implement SHA and then just enable feature flag, but I'm afraid that something may, like, we still can have some objects in the object storage not removed or something if I do that. So I would prefer to do all three of them and only then start enabling feature flag. And basically the current order is that just because I'm already working on the cleaning, so kind of. Not to disrupt.
I'm asking because of that, because if we aim on finishing three of them, we're gonna postponing quite significantly testing of that on GitLab.com. And like we have different ways of cleaning up that later, even like completely wiping out all existing data before migration if we have to. But what I want to focus right now is we get this working, we ask SRI team to provision a bucket for the pages. We configure this bucket and we start deploying to this bucket and we start serving from this bucket. I'm looking for the path that's gonna make us do that in the shortest period of time.
Okay, let's move SHA 256 to the second place and use pages deployments in the zip instead of artifacts to the third place. Because this is also required. Yeah, and then I like in that order we can start testing something.
And really, like my perception would be then, I would really love to start looking at the migration as soon as possible. Kind of like assuming that we may not clean up this data yet, the old data, because in the worst case. If we don't clean up data, we're gonna pay extra price on the storage, but it doesn't really harm us, except that. I think migration is another kind of pretty complex piece, and like I think it's completely acceptable to pay a little more on the object storage initially if we clean up that later, but we have all artifacts migrated and us being able to detach NFS.
Yeah, we can do that, but to be honest, like I don't think that cleaning will take me much time to implement. I don't know. It just feels better that we kind of complete this epic altogether, even though it takes like a couple more days to finish than it would be otherwise. But yeah, and then go to the migration when everything kind of already implemented. I understand like what you're trying to do, but basically, it only will save us a couple of days. I don't know. We will still have this, like, I don't know, worry about this data in the object storage.
You have the item clean pages deployments in object storage when pages are destroyed. What it does mean?
Just run and destroy on every page's deployment in the project. So it's really simple. And there is also the third one. Basically, I wanted to basically create one MR for three things. First is cleaning up when we have new deployments. Second is cleaning up when page is destroyed. And the third one, cleaning up when project is destroyed, because currently page deployments aren't destroyed. But that's just depend on destroy. That's all. So,
So
these are really simple.
Okay. So, let's maybe proceed with that way. But I think like we need like two items here, which is like, I'm not sure if we have the issues for configuring that on github.com.
No, we don't.
Storage bucket. So we need to add the issue for the storage bucket. Where is the issue for the migration? Is it in this one or is it somewhere else?
Yeah, this is this one. But I think we need to add a bucket in the first one. Just, I don't know. Just because we can do that in parallel, I can just ask SREs to provision this bucket as soon as Omnibus settings emerge.
So my suggestion would be like to basically reach to SRE to like to provision this bucket. Once we finish, I even think Omnibus changes as soon as possible, really. Like as soon as we deploy Omnibus changes and the cloud native. Do you have changes cover the CNG or not?
Actually, we don't have anything related to pages in the charts right now. So I just added this like settings for the pages, like for the bigger issue of adding pages to charts. So currently we don't even run front end of the GitLab using charts because it requires the settings. So I don't know if that, so basically, no, we don't have it in the CNG, but it doesn't block us with the current architecture. I mean, with the current state of our productions.
So, like, you can still configure GitLab YML of GitHub in the charts freely to any content that you want?
No, as far as I know, you can't. But basically, right now, we only run, like, we don't run front-end using charts. And we don't run any other components which requires pages using charts. So... as soon as we have Omnibus, we can just set the settings in the Omnibus. And once, I don't know, scalability or delivery team decide that they want to move front end to the charts, then they can. Actually, can you open the add object storage to Omnibus, Jaime? And scroll down a little. Just to very bottom, I guess. Yeah, there is a charts issue in my async update. Yep, this one. So yeah, basically, currently charts that don't support pages at all. So I just added object store settings here and ask delivery team to take care of this. So okay, just cool. Because charts is like way out of my competence at the moment.
Okay, so really like Jason or someone from the delivery team can already start working on that, it appears.
Yeah.
And because like we have the changes on the right side merge, we're gonna have Omnibus changes merge soon, and I believe we're gonna need these charts for the rollout.
Why do you think so?
I'm not sure exactly which part of the stock we run on the Kubernetes. Okay, I think like as soon as we merge Omnibus changes, like we need to reach SRE to provision and configure a bucket for staging and production.
Yeah, yeah.
Just like it's gonna take around probably 1 week to do it. and like this would give us time to finish 256 and API changes.
Yeah, I'll just add it to do for myself and I'll create the issue after this meeting.
So like, do you think that we will be able to start working on the migration in the 13.6?
Yeah, that's the plan. I hope I will finish this like in a couple of weeks and I can go to the migration.
Because like if everything goes fine, we pretty much finish this epic. Like it doesn't seem that there is like really significant blockers right now. The biggest blocker being really like production configuration for us.
Yeah.
Exactly. Okay, one aspect. I'm actually adding that also to our docs. Expose API for pages is currently gonna work only if you have object storage configured. Would you mind maybe like even considering adding a feature flag to allow serving these pages deployments from the disk path or something like that?
You mean on the Rails side or?
Yes, because like I'm assuming that we're gonna create pages deployments regardless if this is local or remote storage. But right now we have to serve API only if the object storage is configured because this is what pages support today only.
Yeah, so basically what you want is just to disable disk deployments in the API for a time being and just to create a feature flag for that, right?
Allow to use the deployments if the dedicated feature flag is used. Yes, something around that. Because like then like it's gonna be quite easy for you to do it once and like then we could coordinate it with Jamie on how to do it on the pages site, I guess.
Yeah. Okay, I'll create an issue for that too. Or I will just do it as a part of the API change issue. Probably the second is better.
So this is probably like the story currently. Would you like copy a link to this charts issue, maybe in the doc? Cool. So I think Rails is pretty nicely covered. I'm super happy of how it looks so far. Should we talk about the Golang version?
Yep, so here's the epic for the Go side.
First of all, I do remember that we had some blockers yesterday, and Camille said that I merged 2 out of 3. So what was the third one?
The first one.
Okay.
Because this is like legitimate bug in supporting the some of the archives that doesn't have public directory archived. So I had to disable the rollout after we receive Zendesk ticket.
Actually, I saw that I merged it. I mean, this is one which adds a directory index and basically extract directory from path of every file and adds it to directory index, right?
No, not yet.
I saw that yesterday. I don't know.
You saw that yesterday, but you did not yet merge it.
One's not merged yet.
Did I have a good reason? I don't remember, actually.
You waited for Jamie approve.
Oh, I see. It's okay.
And you also had suggestion about the tests and like the archive being used. So I extended this archive to test cases where there is no director or and when there is director.
Oh, okay. Okay. Let's skip this suggestion then. Jaime, did you approve it?
Yes, I have.
Okay, then I'll just merge it in, I don't know, when I get to a notice today. So basically, this is the only thing which blocks rollout right now, right?
Yes, I believe that, yes, this is the only thing. Because we're going to have the rule cache, we're going to have 2 additions to the logs. So basically, like right now, we should pretty much be able to have almost ideal implementation except this refresh.
Okay, then...
I'm kind of like expecting that as soon as we do refresh, maybe we improve this caching of the attributes. These are really like the major aspects that we have to do. As for the, let's say, production quality, maybe another aspect like to approach is like making these things configurable, the caches.
Yeah. So basically, I'll merge the SMR. I create the release today. And once it gets merged, we can start the rollout. And basically, like, Pages site is production ready. And then only the Rails site like needs to be worked more at the moment, right?
I mean, like from our, or at least my perspective, like from our testing, it actually behaves pretty well so far. And like with these improvements, it should behave even more predictable. Like we should save these 20 milliseconds on average that we had. So I'm kind of like feeling pretty confident that this is maybe not the production final, but like very close to the expected state, I guess. So
yeah, I do agree. I had one more question actually. I remember that issue about creating a plan limit for number of zip entries. Do we need to do it before we start rollout, or we can do it a little later?
I would even assume that like we completely lack data how big archives are today in the number of the files in the archive. So I'm not sure exactly what the limit should be. Maybe this is actually one of the suggestions would be that as part of the pages deployment, we would retain a number of the files in the archive as a column.
Yeah, actually, that's a good idea.
So, so really not yet page plan limits, but we archive everything as is today, But like we retain amount of the files being archived, so we can kind of decide what to do with that next and what the limits to pick, because we're gonna run the migration on the GitLab.com, and as soon as we migrate, we know how many of them are escaping the limits or something.
Yeah. Agree. Also, a couple questions. Can I get SHA 256 and the number of entries from the metadata or from Artifacts archive? Or I need to go through the archive?
Artifacts archive does have SHA-256 already. So like you can copy that value. As for the number of the files, like just use metadata count.
Okay, so it is there.
It's like, I mean, like it has all the files listed, but there is one thing, like you should not filter that by public directory. You should rather take a total number of the files in the archive.
Yeah.
At least from the current implementation standpoint, we care about the total amount of the files, not the files in the public. It may change later if we do some kind of crazy shenanigans on like rewriting maybe, but the problem of 100,000 is the problem of reading 100,000 as part of the read archive today. So yes, answering your question, like you have both of these data easily accessible
today. Yeah. Okay. Anything else you want to discuss?
So is there anything on this list, Camille, that you think we should prioritize for 13.6?
The caching?
Yep, so we have this on the second spot.
I would even say that maybe more important is the negative cache, so like handling of the errors, okay, than the caching refresh. I mean, okay, like...
They are
probably similar, but the tricky part, if we add zip cache refresh, this is gonna be retained forever. Right now, you're gonna have the failure only to like, I guess, 1 minute. So I would say that we should fix the caching, like archive opening errors, to make it like fix itself first. Yeah. Before we start retaining archive forever. I like looking at the metrics, like I saw 100,000 of the archives of opened properly, but I saw 2 being invalid as well. So happening very rarely, but it is happening, and it's quite hard really to like resolve that without having to restart pages. So I guess error handling should be our priority right now to consider production readiness.
Okay. That makes sense.
As for the other items, I think it's pretty important to make these aspects that we have hard-coded being configurable.
Yep.
So we could start playing with different values as well on the production. So my perception would be to make this cache entries configurable after the refresh being done.
Yep.
Because right now we have a bunch of the hard-coded values. And for example, one thing that I'm worried about is like, let's say we increase the rollout percentage to 100% and we saw the cache miss rate to be 50%, for example. It's impossible, but let's say that this is 50%. We have to make change to GitLab pages to fix that, where like we should aim to having this config focused. So I'm kind of like looking for that. If we make it configurable, we can find, let's say, kind of magic setting that make us to have pretty high hit rate, retain archives for pretty long as well, for as long as it is possible, looking at our memory usage. But like allowing that before memory usage to be reasonable with the growing percentage. So they're gonna be a little playing with the caching values. And really, I think the last one from that list is like allow to serve zip from the disk pages, I guess. Like,
yep.
It's probably in the right place there.
Okay. Cool. Thanks for that.
So I'm kind of like would love that like we finish up to the a configurable aspect in the 13.6 milestone.
Yep. Oh.
And like I think as soon as we like fix the negative cache, we fix the cache configurable, I would then consider this like be, let's say, production ready after we continue running that on this 10% rollout that we can run today.
Okay, anything else?
I'm kind of wondering how important is this last item from the pages list, handle extra headers?
It was just a follow-up after the one of the MRs. I guess if nobody noticed that it doesn't work, we can skip. At the same time, like, it actually makes browser cache work better, so
we can move it out of this epic. Maybe just keep it open.
I'm not sure exactly how it affects like the user experience, because like the lack of these headers make the browser each time to like to reload the entity basically fully from the server. So it kind of increases the pressure, like even if you have the same content already stored.
Yeah, I think we can do it later. Like, I don't know, basically once we've done everything else, we can get back to this if need. Are you suggesting that we like skip it forever and never do?
I'm actually thinking that it may be quite important to do it. From the like, let's say, performance point of view, egress traffic, the cost of like not having that in the end, right? Because yeah. like if you have big image that doesn't change ever, like it impacts our egress traffic and inflates it, and like we paid a ton of money for egress traffic. So this is pretty easy and pretty important optimization. Maybe like we should finish that. After we make cache configurable.
Jaime, can you open the Epic?
Yeah. So pump it up.
Yeah, so like we focus on the cache configurable. Once we do it, we try to take bite on these headers to improve the performance of pages and clients. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, testing and rollout. Can we put the link there in the doc?
What link do you want, like the production change issue or?
For example. Do we need maybe some kind of epic or like, is this single issue like the right item like to track, including all our rollouts that we are doing? Because as for the rollout, right now, we have SRE issue for configuring buckets. We have these rollout changes. We soon gonna have, we're gonna be toggling on and off HS deployments, feature flag for creating. We're gonna be toggling API, and then we're gonna have the issue for the rollout of the migration and ensuring that this works properly. I'm kind of wondering like how we can better structure the work items of the rollout that that makes it like visible for our production team. Because I would assume that from the perspective of the scalability and cloud native group, they care about the rollout issue, how far we are in the rollout, what is the progress of that, what are the different pieces, where like implementation and aspects of the implementation are not super relevant to them. So I'm kind of like wondering if this single change management issue is good enough given a multitude of the aspects that we're gonna be going out on the production.
Yeah, I just create an epic for the all rollout issues. We already have like two or three of them. I'll just put all of them into the same epic and link it in the transition GitLab pages issue. Epic, I mean. And it will be kind of the index of all rollouts we have. Does it sound right?
Yeah, so I would assume that we put the issue for configuring bucket for staging and configuring bucket for the production there, because this is part of the rollout. This issue that we have now that would also land there, I would assume that we would have the separate issue for the pages deployment, creating that and like tracking how it's behaving, maybe even closing that. And then like the API changes. Create the API, I'm just gonna create additional issues for these items to help you a little with that, because you have a lot of issues to create already.
Let's do it this way. I'll just create an like almost empty epic, put a few issues I already have at hand. Because a few of issues you mentioned, I do already have created in different places. And then I'll just ping you there and you can finish it.
Cool.
Okay, let's do it this way. Okay, we're just a little over time. Anything else to discuss?
I think that I know everything. Thank you.
Okay, great. Jaime?
I think I'm good. Thanks.
Okay. Sean, Klaas?
I have just one random question about the migration. What we're gonna do with projects that haven't built for a while and we don't have artifacts for them?
Well, just basically the whole migration will be just scanning disk for all the projects. Basically, I will just take the projects which have pages enabled with using pages metadata, and then I just will zip what we currently have.
So we'll create the zips files ourselves.
Yeah, we won't use artifacts for migration.
Yeah, okay, thank you. Well, that's all I needed to know. Okay, thanks.
Okay, thanks everyone. I guess thanks. That was quite productive meeting.
Yeah.
Have a good day.
Bye, see ya.
Ciao.